to open a new file. Click on file. New option. You will get this new dialog box. Give the name of the file that you want to give. Suppose I am taking it as first project. Then size of the stage, that is the width and height of the stage or the working area canvas. And it is can be given in pixels, inches, centimeters, millimeters, points, meters, or columns. Whatever things you want to, whatever unit of measurement you want to take, you can take. Suppose I am taking in pixels or inches. I am taking it pixels, 1920 by 1080. Resolution and color mode, rest them to the default settings. Don't change them. Then there is a background content. Background content can be white. It can be background color. It can be transparent. So if I want, by default it is going with the white, it will give me a white canvas. But if I want to take some like this, this is a blank canvas, so white canvas are. If I want to take some background color, what I can do? I can change the background color here. Here in the tools palette, you will see there is a foreground color and a background color. I will click on this, choose a background color that you want to have, any background color. Then click on OK. Now this background color has been filled here. Now I'm going to file menu, new option, giving the size of the stage. Suppose now I'm giving it as 1020 pixels by 800 pixels. You can also give in inches. Click on OK. Oh, I forgot to change the option. New here it is background color. Change the background color. Whatever background color has been selected in the tools palette, that will be applied like this. I think this thing we had done in the last week also. Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, now I'm going to open an image and place an image. Last week I told you in the tools palettes, we are having the layers panel. In the layers panel is there. By default, there is a blank layer, background layer, single layer. Okay, and this layer is locked also. Now if I open an image, click on file menu, open option, open dialog box is there. Choose any image that you want to open. Click on open. Now what will happen? It is opening an image. Okay. In the layers panel, you will see there is a background image, background layer, and with this image is on the background layer. Only one layer is there. That becomes a background layer. जो भी image हमने open करी है, that will become as the background layer. That will become as the base. On the top of which I can insert any number of objects. Any number of layers can be inserted. Any number of objects can be inserted on the top of it. This is the background layer. Okay? When we open an image, that image is opened as a background layer in a new file. In a new file. This is important. This is a new file with the background image. Now I'm taking this blank canvas. I'm going to place an image. When I place an image, what will happen? I click an image, I place it here. Now what happened? It is not a new file. जो file मैंने already open करी है, उसी के अंदर एक new file, एक image place हो गई है on the blank canvas, on the background image. Now in the layers panel, you will see there are two layers. One is the background layer, जो blank था मेरा, उसके ऊपर मैंने एक image insert करी है, place करी है. So that is given on a different layer. When I open an image, it will become a new file and it will open as a background layer. But when I place an image, it is placed on the top of other objects in a new layer. Okay, it is placed on the top of other objects in a new layer. Now I can move it. Because transformation handles are there already, when I placed it, I can move it, I can place it, I can resize it, whatever I want to do. When I'm satisfied with its position and its size, I can press the enter key to remove the transformation handles. Okay? Now Now I'm going to place one more image. When I want to place the image, I can place any number of objects. I'm going to open it, place. Now this image has been placed. Now in the layers panel, you will see there are three layers now. One is the background layer. One is the image that I had already inserted. Then second image that I had inserted, it is again in the new layer. I can resize it. I can move it. Now it is coming at the top of this. If I want it to go in the background, I can change the size, order of the layer. Press enter. Now this image has been placed. But I want कि ये जो भी मैंने second image insert करी है, this should go in the background of this layer. So I can drag the layers like this and change the order. See, order has been changed. Now this image is in the background. At the back of first image. Now, if I want to deal with this first image, select the image. Control plus T, that is a shortcut key for transform. Please, everyone, take your copies in your hand or in your books. Take your pencils or pens. Write down the shortcut keys which are I'm mentioning again and again. बहुत सारी shortcut keys बताऊंगी जो book में नहीं दी हुई हैं. बहुत सारे tools के uses भी आएंगे जो आपको book में नहीं दिए होंगे. Now these are the things, these are not given in book, how we can change the order of layers. We can change the order of layer by dragging. There is a image or menu. Image menu ke andar, sorry. Edit menu. There is a transform option, pre-transform. There is an option, pre-transform. That is a shortcut key, control plus T. You can press the shortcut key. Now this image is selected. I can move it like this. Again changes. Press enter key. Now if I want to deal with this layer, this white layer, I can click on this layer. Now I can press the shortcut key, control plus T. Now its handles will appear. And I can adjust it like this. Now press enter key. Clear? Is it clear? Difference of place and open is clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Any doubt? Place or open mein koi doubt hai kisi ko? Suppose I had opened this image. He has a background key. I can place any image at the top of this also. It doesn't mean ki mujhe jo place karni hai images wo sirf background layer pe ya blank layer pe ho sakti hai. Aap kisi bhi image ko open karke uske upar bhi kuch rakh sakte ho aur images place kar sakte ho. I'm placing it. I'm resizing it. I am moving it and adjusting it somewhere. Like this, ठीक है, and press enter. Now in the layers panel, you will see there is a background image, ठीक है, and there is a image that I had placed on the top of it. Clear? Is it clear? Yes, Arman, Japuji, Pragati, is it clear how to open an image or how to place an image?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, now we are going to start with the Marquee tool, selection tool. That tool you had done last year also. Okay, Marquee tool. There are four Marquee tools. That is a rectangular Marquee tool, elliptical Marquee tool, single row and single column Marquee tool. Rectangular Marquee tool, as the name suggests, it is used to select the rectangular or square portions of your image. And the elliptical Marquee tool is used to select the rectangular, circular, or elliptical portions of your image. Okay. Now, single row or single column. Single row will select a single row in the whole image, single pixel. It is selecting the single pixel in the whole image. पूरी एक image के अंदर single row इसने select करी है, but one pixel. Now similarly, I can select a single column. If I want to select a single pixel as a column wise, I can click here. It will select a single column. Now what I can do by selecting the image? क्या क्या कर सकते हैं हम image को select करके? Anybody? Why we need to select an image? Yes. Any idea?
Editing.
Yes.
मैम एडिटिंग के लिए कॉपी पेस्ट
क्या चाहिए प्लीज रिपीट इट क्या बोला बेटा आपने
मैम टू एडिट टू कॉपी पेस्ट
ओके टू एडिट टू कॉपी और टू पेस्ट राइट यू कैन सेलेक्ट द इमेज यू कैन कॉपी इट एंड यू कैन पेस्ट इट एनीवेयर एनीथिंग एल्स और कुछ कर सकते हैं बेटा देर आर सो मेनी यूजेस ऑफ द मार्क्यू टूल और सिलेक्शन टूल एनी सिलेक्शन टूल देर आर सो मेनी यूजेस वन यूज इज यू कैन सेलेक्ट द पोर्शन ऑफ द एरिया पोर्शन ऑफ द इमेज इन विच यू वॉन्ट टू चेंज द कलर यू कैन सेलेक्ट द पोर्शन ऑफ द इमेज सपोज यू वॉन्ट टू ड्रॉ समथिंग बाई यूजिंग द ब्रश टूल और यू वॉन्ट टू चेंज द पैटर्न ऑफ एनी कलर ऑफ योर ड्रेस तो यू हैव टू सेलेक्ट दैट पार्ट ऑफ द इमेज आपको जिस पोर्शन को सेलेक्ट करना है उस पोर्शन को हम कलर चेंज कर सकते हैं उस पोर्शन में हम ग्रेडियंट फिल कर सकते हैं उतने ही पोर्शन में हम ब्रश टूल के साथ पैटर्न्स ड्रॉ कर सकते हैं बाय डिफॉल्ट हम ब्रश टूल के साथ जब भी पैटर्न्स या ड्राइंग करेंगे फ्री हैंड ड्राइंग है इट कैन गो एनीवेयर आउटसाइड द एरिया जो डिजायर्ड एरिया से बाहर कहीं भी ड्रॉ हो सकती है बट इफ वी सेलेक्ट दैट एरिया इन विच वी वॉन्ट टू फिल द पैटर्न बाय यूजिंग द ब्रश टूल सो इट विल फिल ओनली इनसाइड दैट एरिया I can use the paint bucket tool to fill the color. I can use a gradient tool to fill the gradients in the selected area only. Okay. Now see, there are suppose I'm selecting this area. Now I want to add to the selection. I want कि मुझे इतना area select कर लिया, मुझे ये भी area साथ में select करना है, अलग-अलग है, if distance पे है. I want to select this portion also. But whenever I select the area, it will deselect the previous area. Right? So what I can do, there are few options in the option bar, context menu पर ध्यान दो, add to selection, subtract from selection and intersect with selection. Add to selection अगर मैं click कर रही हूँ, now what will happen? You can see mouse pointer के साथ एक plus sign आ रहा है. I'm selecting it. It is adding to the selection. Clear? I can select the multiple parts of the image. Then there is a subtract from image, subtract from selection. Selected, now mouse pointer ke saath ek minus sign aa raha hai. I want to deselect this portion. Sirf itna portion deselect karna hai, baki selected rahega. I am subtracting from this selection. Now see, jitna area maine select kiya, wo subtract ho gaya. Now I want to subtract this part. That part is deselected, rest of the area is selected. Similarly, I can intersect with selection. I'm taking the elliptical tool. I'm taking the option of intersect with selection. Intersect with selection means now there is a multiple sign with the pointer. Intersect with selection means this area which has been already selected. Now the area which I am going to select, where both areas intersect with each other, that area should be selected. I'm taking it like this. Now, both areas जहां पर intersect कर रहे हैं that area will be selected. Rest of the area is removed. Okay? This is the intersection. Now, what can I do with this? Suppose I'm taking the normal selection. I'm selecting this area. Okay? Now, there is a shortcut key also. To add to selection and subtract from selection. Please write down the shortcut keys. Write down the shortcut keys. You can press. Now, what is the benefit for using the shortcut key? One is ki aapko jab bhi option bar se option add to selection ya subtract to selection ya intersect from selection use karoge, aapko wapis jaake usko deselect karna padta hai. If you want to go to the new selection or if you want to add to subtract karna hai, ab add karna hai, ab new pe jana hai, to aapko baar baar ek option select karne ke baad wapis option bar mein jaake usko deselect karna padta hai. Next, otherwise that option will apply to the further selections also. मुझे further selection में add to selection नहीं चाहिए, मुझे further selections में subtract भी नहीं चाहिए, मुझे new चाहिए, तो मुझे वहां जाके वापस deselect करना पड़ेगा. तो shortcut keys का benefit ये होता है, they apply only to the current selection. Second, one benefit तो ये हो गया कि आपको बार बार option bar में जाके option को select नहीं करना है, deselect नहीं करना है. सेकेंड बेनिफिट ये होता है कि वो ज्यादा क्विक होती है, आपकी सिर्फ करंट सिलेक्शन पे अप्लाई हो रही है, आपको बार बार माउस पॉइंटर को एडजस्ट नहीं करना है ऑप्शन बार पे जाके, आपको सिर्फ कीबोर्ड से की प्रेस करनी है और माउस के साथ सिलेक्ट करते जाना है. प्रेस द शिफ्ट की, यू विल सी अ प्लस साइन इज देयर विद द माउस पॉइंटर. कैन यू सी दिस प्लस साइन? काइंडली स्विच ऑन योर कैमराज, काइंडली स्विच ऑन योर कैमराज सो दैट आई कैन सी यू आर गेटिंग माई पॉइंट. Okay, now plus sign is there. I can drag it, drag it. It is getting me the plus sign. I leave it. Now it is again new selection. I do not have to select it from option bar. I do not have to deselect it again. Now, if I want to subtract, press the Alt key. Write down the key. Shift key, add to selection. Alt key, subtract from selection. Now press the Alt key. And select the area it was deselected. Subtract from selection. Like this. I had told you three keys today. One, Control plus T for pre-transform. Shift key, add to selection. Alt key, subtract from selection. Yes, Jayant?
Ma'am, pre-transform ke spelling kya hai?
Pre-transform, TRANSFORM, edit menu, here you can see, pre-transform, shortcut key, control plus T. Now, I can tell you, this is a paint bucket tool, this tool you had used last year also, am I right? To fill the colors, right? Now, if I select it, paint bucket, I click here, foreground color will be filled. Pattern, I have selected pattern here. Okay, foreground color. Now foreground color will be filled in all the selected areas. Okay? Selection ka ek fayda to ye ho gaya. You can fill the selected areas, all the selected areas with single color. Now I'm going, what is the shortcut key to deselect the area? I want to deselect all this. Jitna selection hai, mujhe selection ko deselect karna hai. What is the shortcut key to deselect? Anyone? Quickly. We have so many things to do now. Control plus D. D. T for transform. D for deselect. Control plus D. Shortcut key to deselect the selected area. Please write down. Control plus D. I'm going to undo it. All the selections. Now I'm going to take the rectangle tool. I'm going to make some borders around the stage. मैंने एक एरिया ये सेलेक्ट कर लिया, ठीक है? I'm selecting one area at the top and I'm selecting one area at the bottom. How? By pressing the shift key. By pressing the shift key, I'm adding this area here. Now I can fill the gradients, I can fill the single color, or I can use the brush tool. I'm using the brush tool here. Take any pattern, brush tool aapne thoda bahut last year learn kiya hai, use kiya hai. Am I right? Please give me response. Had you used the brush tool last year? Yes or no? Take any pattern. Take any pattern from brush tool. Okay, I'm taking a one pattern. Change the color. I'm changing the color here for the brush. Click on OK. Okay, now I'm dragging it. Now see what will happen. It is filling only the selected area, not outside. I am filling this area. It is not giving point outside the selected area. Clear? Is it clear to everyone? How we can use the
selection? Ma'am, which tool you have
used first? I had used the brush tool, beta. मैंने brush tool में से एक pattern लिया है. I have taken a pattern from the brush tool. You can take any pattern. These are the patterns for brush tool. Suppose I am taking some other pattern. हाँ जी, any doubt? यहाँ से brush tool में बेटा you can take any pattern from here. Suppose this pattern I am taking, ठीक है? I am undoing this fill color. Now I can fill this pattern. It will not go outside. It will remain inside the selected area. You can draw beautiful patterns as a sketch in the background or in the selected area. Give borders, anything. Okay, clear? Is it clear? Now suppose I want to give borders around the four sides. What I can do? Now I'm deselecting this area. I'm undoing this. Okay, what is the shortcut key for undo?
Ma'am, your voice is shrinking.
Okay. Yes, ma'am. Now is it audible?
Yes, ma'am. Now your voice is audible.
Okay, ma'am, your voice is now audible.
Okay, thank you. Now I'm going to undo this command. मुझे ये pattern हटाना है. What is the shortcut key for undo? Anyone? Hurry up quickly. ये तुमने बहुत बार use की है. What is the shortcut key for undo? Yes, Somil?
Control plus Z.
But in Photoshop, we cannot undo more than one action by using the undo command or undo control plus Z. See, we cannot undo more than one action. We can undo or go to step backward by using the step backward option, and the shortcut key is Alt plus Control plus Z. Alt plus Control plus Z. For cancelling more than one action, ठीक है? To do more than one action, to undo more than one action, Control plus Alt plus Z. Write down the shortcut key to undo more than one action. Control plus Alt plus Z. Option is in Edit menu. Now I'm undoing it. Now I'm going to take rectangular marquee tool. I had selected this area. ठीक है, I'm selecting this area. Now I want कि जो मेरे pattern fill करना है मुझे, जो मैंने अभी brush का pattern fill करा था, I want to fill the pattern outside this selected area. मुझे selected area में fill नहीं करना है, outside this selected area I want to fill. Now that means I have to deselect this area and select the outside area. In one click only. What I can do, go to the select menu. There is an option inverse. Inverse selection. That means reverse the selected area. Jo area selected hai, wo deselect ho jayega. Aur jo area unselected hai, wo select ho jayega. Shortcut key, Shift plus Control plus I. Now see. Ab charo sides pe mera pattern selected hai. I can take the brush tool. Choose any pattern, or I can fill the gradient also. Take any pattern. Here I'm taking some leaves. I'm changing the color of leaves. Click OK. I want to increase the size of brush also. Anybody knows what is the shortcut key to increase the size of brush? I can increase it from here. I can fill it like this. It will not go outside. चाहे आपका माउस पॉइंटर जहां मर्जी मूव करे, आपका पॉइंटर, इट विल नॉट गो आउटसाइड द सिलेक्टेड एरिया. Now see, I had draw a beautiful pattern as a border. Now control plus D for deselecting. Anji, is it okay? Is it interesting? Will you try this?
Yes, ma'am.
Will you try this now?
Yes, ma'am.
These are the various things that you can do with the help of this selection tools only. Now I'm going to tell you one more thing. You can take your own photographs. You may be having your own photographs at your home, in your computers. You can apply effects by using the selection tool. How? I'm going to tell you a few more shortcut keys. Please note down them. Okay? Note down those shortcut keys. There was one more picture here. Okay, this one. Okay? I'm taking the foreground color as black or gray, and I'm taking the background color as white. Okay? Now I'm going to select the area that I want to highlight, and the rest of area I want to give some blur effect, fill effect. Okay? I told you, you can use the paint bucket tool to fill the area, right? Now I have selected this area. I want to keep this area as intact, and I want to fill some color outside this area. So first of all, I had to inverse the selection. What is the shortcut key to inverse the selection? अभी अभी बताइए मैंने, what is the shortcut key to inverse the selection?
Control plus I.
Yes, control plus I. Plus I. Now this area has been selected. Now the reverse area has been selected. Now I want to fill the color. One phrase, you can fill the color by using this paint bucket tool. Shortcut key is control plus backspace. It fills the background color. Background color is white here. And alt plus backspace, that will fill the foreground color, that is gray here. जो मैंने यहाँ select किया हुआ. Alt plus backspace, it will fill the foreground color in the selected area. Write it down. आपको भूल जाएंगी बाद में ये सारी shortcut keys. Alt plus backspace, it will fill foreground color in the selected area. And control plus backspace will fill background color in selected area. Now, I'm going to undo this. Now, I'm going to do one more thing. मुझे जो fill करना है color, वो मुझे totally fill ऐसे dark वाला solid fill नहीं करना है. मुझे इसमें transparency चाहिए थोड़ी सी, feather effect चाहिए. कैसे करेंगे? Right click on the selected area, choose the feather option. Now, I can give the number of pixels as that I want as a radius for the feather around this. Now that depends the number of pixels हमने कितने देने हैं, that depends on the size of image. As you can see, this image that जो मुझे अभी नजर आ रही है वो 16% है सिर्फ.
मैम आपका right click sir, मैम आपका right.
If I do it 100%, that size of the pixel will.
मैम your voice is shrinking.
Again shrinking.
मैम your video is also lagging.
फेदर डायलॉग बॉक्स ओपन करना आ गया. राइट क्लिक, चूज द फेदर ऑप्शन. फेदर रेडियस इज देयर. गिव द नंबर ऑफ पिक्सल्स. सपोज आई एम टेकिंग इट एज 500 पिक्सल्स. क्लिक ऑन ओके. नाउ आई एम गोइंग टू फिल द कलर. ऑल्ट प्लस बैकस्पेस. Now you see, पहले हमने background color fill किया था तो solid आया था. अब मैंने feather effect देने के बाद background color fill किया तो क्या हुआ? It is transparent. कितने pixels तक उसने उसको feather radius effect दे दिया थोड़ा सा transparency के साथ. Undo, select, deselect it, control plus D. Yes.
मैम आपकी वीडियो मैम स्टक हो गई थी, अब ठीक हो गई है.
अब ठीक हो गया बेटा. जस्ट वेट, मे बी सम. Is it clear to everyone? I'm showing you one more time. Suppose I'm taking another image. This image is there. Just watch the steps carefully. Select the image that you want to keep as intact in the center. Okay? Take it as like this. Select the image that you want to keep. Select the portion of image. Then reverse the selection. Control plus Shift plus I. Select the background color that you want to fill or foreground color. Click on OK.
Ma'am, screen is not shared.
OK.
Yes, ma'am.
Now is it OK?
Screen is not visible. Your video is also stopped.
Now, ab dekho, ab nazar aa raha hai.
Ma'am, your voice is also not audible.
Beta, just wait kar liya karo do minute. Just wait. Ab audible hai?
Ma'am, no, it is not.
Okay, now I had selected the area. I had reversed the selection again. Select kar liya. Control plus Shift ke I plus I ke saath inverse kiya. Now, I'm changing the feather effect. Right click. Feather. Choose the number of pixels. Click on OK. Now fill the color. Alt plus backspace. It is giving me the foreground color like this. You can give Control plus D shortcut key to deselect. In this way, you can give the effects to your own photographs. Okay. Tomorrow before class, you will try this effect. And tomorrow we will continue with this, your further selection, magic wand.